and there's no reason to suspect that today will be any different. Eight pairs of divers will compete in six rounds, the first two of which are the compulsory dives with a tariff of 2.0. Then we're on to the optionals, the ones chosen by the divers, which range from a 3.0 for Canada right up to 3.8 from Russia, Great Britain, Mexico, China and Ukraine. Here come the pairs in order. Russia, followed by the USA, Christian Ibsen and Troy Dumais. And there should be a big cheer coming up next. The Great Britain pair of Chris Mears and Nick Robinson-Baker. Get ready for an eruption. Just a few people inside the Aquatic Centre on this Wednesday afternoon. Here come the Mexicans. What a week they've had so far. Two silver medals. It's Yael Castillo and Julian Sanchez for them. Malaysian pair of Brian Lomas and Huang Qiang. And the Chinese pair, who are the world champions. It's Qin and Liu from Ukraine. Ilya Kavasha and Alexei Grigorov. And finally, familiar face to your right, you've been seeing him on your television screens for, 14 years now, Alex Despatie with Ruben Ross. One other important name to mention, that's my co-conspirator in commentary today. 2004 silver medalist in the 10-meter synchro, Leon Taylor. Welcome.
Thanks, Bob. In final synchronized diving contest of these Olympic Games here in London, and it's 3 out of 3 so far for China. And I'm sorry to let you know, those of you hoping to see someone else take the gold spot, I would say that this is their strongest event. The men's 3 meter synchro, 6 dives, 8 pairs. The Russians start number one. Yeah, the smart money's on them for a silver medal. They have got the highest degree of difficulty out of anyone, including the Chinese. And we saw how well that worked for the Mexican pair on the men's 10-meter synchro. So this is going to be exciting contest. It's going to be tough on our boys, Chris Mears and Nicholas Robinson-Baker, with the home crowd behind them. Maybe they can lift their game. Of course, they wouldn't have qualified for this. The only reason they are competing is because of the host nation being given a spot. So they've got their work cut out, but everyone else has earned their spot. The other 7 pairs, obviously the creme de la creme of springboard synchronized men's diving, and of course the Chinese to beat. Here we go, the all-important list of the judges. Now, I'll take the time now to explain the judging, because it's been slightly modified from the World Championships in Shanghai last year. We now, instead of having 4 execution judges, we have 6. Now, 3 on one side of the pool and 3 on the other. The highest and lowest per diver is discounted to leave you 1 execution mark for each of the divers. The synchronization judges, 5 of them, are split across both sides of the pool, and the highest and lowest of those 5 are discounted as well to leave you 5 raw scores, if you will, which are then multiplied by the degree of difficulty for the dive. It's then multiplied by 0.6 to give you the total. You don't need to worry about too much about the complex calculations. What you do need to know is the intention behind it is to make it fairer by always averaging out the scores. And of course, the most important thing is weighted towards the synchronization. So what we're looking for today is perfect unison. Divers should be hitting the water at exactly the same time. Of course, they should be taking off from the springboard at exactly the same time. They should be rotating at the same speed. They should also be the same distance from the diving board. So look out for that today. Execution marks, obviously looking for the completely vertical entry into the water without a droplet of splash. That's where you're going to get the most marks. And let's get the competition underway.
The 1-8 will be Russia, USA, Great Britain, Mexico, Malaysia, China, Ukraine and Canada. So first up, it is Zakharov and Kuznetsov. First 2 rounds of dives will all have the same tariff, 2.0. They will all be different kinds of dives, though. The opening one from the Russians is a back dive with pike.
Beautiful opening dive from the Russian pair. As I mentioned before in the preview, I think these boys are certainly the second strongest team in this field. Zakharov there closest to us, already competed in the platform synchro. Backward dive, so up, pike position, touching the toes. Beautiful lines into the water, rip entries, hardly any splash. Bag full of nines to kick off the Russians' campaign.
That's a pretty lively start from the Russians. 54 from them, 3 nines on synchro. That's the kind of opening you want to a competition of this magnitude. Now the USA, plenty of support for them. You see the Star Spangled Banner on the far side. They'll be able to see that too. Christian Ibsen and Troy Dumay, very experienced, especially Troy, been around for quite some time. And you'll get a chance to see exactly the same dive being performed by the Americans. It is a back dive with pike. And just to remind you again, all these first two round dives have 2.0 degree of difficulty.
Fantastic start from the US. Troy Dumay, 32 years old, been around for many, many years at this highest level. Christian, much younger than him, only 19, but they seem to have a few years behind them as a pair. Arm swing, reaching up, touching the toes into the pike shape, arm movement at the same time. You could check the alignment there, maybe a slight discrepancy, not as good as the Russians, like for like. Russia number one, USA number two.
Yeah, 51.60, not as good. Gone from nines to 8.5s for the USA. Big cheer. Nick Robinson-Baker will be enjoying this. I'm sure Chris Mears will likewise. Great having this kind of home support behind you. And they're going to go for exactly the same dive in exactly the same position. It's the back dive with pike. 54 for the Russians, 51.60 for the USA.
Solid opening for the home pairing, and the crowd enjoy it. Union Jack's being waving to everyone in the crowd. Here we go, swinging the arms. You can see this like for like out of the dive at the same time, moving the arms at the same time. Oh, let's see, that might split the Russians and the Americans. But most importantly, they're staying in contention. All about precision. Tom Daly, Tonya Couch there, already competed. Great support for this home pairing of Chris Mears, first Olympic Games, only 19 years old, on his way back to find a quiet spot in between rounds. Canadian pair just coming through.
Yeah, not a lot of room down there, so you have to battle for your space. And second place now for Great Britain in round one. Now the Mexican pair, Castillo Huerta and Sanchez Gallegos. And just for a bit of variety, they're going to go for an inward 1.5 somersaults with pike. Sounds a bit more complicated, but worth exactly the same in terms of tariff.
Oh, that's much better than it's been in the training. Certainly the Mexican boys up on the platform were a bit shaky on their first two. Those of you that were watching a couple of days ago, Yael Castillo and his partner here making no mistake about it. Beautiful synchronization, 1.5 somersaults. Inward, of course, spinning forwards towards the diving board where you start with your back facing the water. You've got to move away from the diving board. I think that's going to put them close to the lead. That's a beautiful opening dive.
Well, we enjoyed the Russians. The judges enjoyed that just a tad more. 54.60 gives them a slender first round lead. On to the Malaysian pair of Huang and Brian Lomas. And you saw this one in the first three pairings. It is a back dive performed in the pike position.
Oh, another beautiful opening dive. No one giving anything away, as you would expect in these limited degree of difficulty rounds. Huang closest to us there. Interesting story. I competed against him when he used to dive for China back in 99 and 2000. In fact, a world medalist himself for China. Went over to Malaysia to become a coach, and now he's competing for Malaysia. Fantastic opening dive there from the two divers. Wow, this is shaping up to be very, very close, Bob.
What a contest already, isn't it? And even in the first round, before we get into the real meat and two veg, as I like to call it, from round three onwards, four rounds of optionals. which has a range from 3.0 up to 3.8. And Great Britain will be one of those pairs doing the 3.8, the 4.5, which I know has you on the edge of your seats. China, world champions. What are they going to do? Well, we know what we expect them to do on their opening back dive.
Very precise. Excellent rip entries into the water. The coach is there acknowledging the effort the divers are putting in. It's all about being poised, executing these dives perfectly. And we're getting a diving masterclass already from the Chinese. That'll put them in the lead. Exactly the same distance from the diving board. Look at those entries into the water. They're going to get 9s, 9.5s on execution, and then the synchros will be up there in the 9s and 9.5s. There we go. Interesting shot to go to, but getting the water out of his ears into the hot tub Big for a little relax.
9.5s on the right, 9s on the left. 56.40 for the Chinese pair, and we expect them to be just there come round six. Now, the European bronze medalists and bronze medalists in Beijing 4 years ago, Ilya Kavasha on Alexei Grigorov. And once again, you know this well by now, it's a back dive.
Yeah, it's pretty good. I did notice diver closest to us there with what I thought was a tattoo. But in closer inspection, it's actually some very fancy taping. I know we saw it at Wimbledon in the tennis a few weeks ago with all this bright coloured fancy taping. The Ukrainian diver there going for black. Not quite sure what the physios are doing. Maybe some of you want to tweet me and explain the benefits of that kind of taping. But I don't know whether it's... who knows? Anyway, didn't affect their first dive. They are a little off the pace with that, with only 51.
What's that holding together?
I don't know. That's why I'm asking the experts,
really,
Bob.
Strange.
Come on, physios, let us know.
Anyway, 51 is nothing special from Ukraine. Good to see Alex Despartis here. After getting a nasty injury in preparation for this event, here he is with Ruben Ross, and they're going for a forward dive.
Yeah, probably a little bit more risky because you've got the hurdle step approach. A few more things can go wrong as you're walking down the board together, leaping from 1 foot onto two. Alex Despartis closest to us there. I'll tell you more about his injury shortly. Look at that beautiful elevation. Is Ruben Ross a little further away from the diving board? Yes, he is. Remember, the judges do not get to see the replay. This is for me, for Bob, and for you all at home or wherever you are, on the bus, on the train, in an aeroplane, who knows where you might be watching this. But that's a pretty good opening round dive from all of the pairs. And I think the Canadians will certainly be in the top half of the field. What do you think, Bob?
Yeah, it's all right. It's a pretty decent opening. And that will give them equal third place after the first round. Here are the standings after the first round that's been completed by all eight divers. And China, Mexico, Canada level in third. And Great Britain not on the bottom. The USA and Ukraine are behind Mears and Robinson Baker. And the crowd quite happy to see them a few places below the top, but a couple of places above the bottom. Great view. Got to say, some of the camera work here has been spectacular. You wait until we get to the platform competition a week on Friday, and the finals a week on Saturday. Some of the pictures are astonishing. Zakharov and Kuznetsov still, of course, in the compulsories. And it's reverse 1.5 somersaults with half a twist.
Oh, you hear the stamp on the diving board there. That didn't sound, well, as it should. You should be pressing into the diving board. It was all about the rhythm. And that was a bit of a stamp on the springboard there. This isn't gymnastics. This is diving. Look how much the boards bend as they elevate up in the air. It's so beautiful when they get it right. But actually, a bit of a hodgepodge there from the Russians. They're not going to get completely penalized, but that's nowhere near as good as their opening dive. Probably a little over 50 points. They will be disappointed with that. Interesting.
It wouldn't be a commentary without one of Leon's hodgepodges, would it? Let's be honest. 51.60 from Zakharov and Kuznetsov. And after a great opening dive, that was just a little bit below par in comparison. On to second diving combination of Christian Ibsen And as saying, the very experienced Troy Dumais find themselves below the Brits after the first round. Here they are with their inward dive, this one in the tuck position.
Yeah, the Americans choosing to mix it up a little bit and doing a very, very good job there. You know, these first two rounds of dives, so all the pairs are going to be a little bit nervous. If you're a little shaky, you can certainly make a bit of a hash-up of these dives. There we are, beautiful inward, of course, jumping backwards, forwards towards the diving board in the slight rotation. Little bit of splash going in, but I'm pretty sure that they're going to get nines on the synchro. And yeah, that's going to keep them well in contention. Early days yet.
Yeah, it moves them up a fraction. 53.40 for Ibsen and Dumais. Now, what do we have here? We have a crowd getting rather excited at the arrival of the British pair. There's Chris Mears, and there's Nick Robinson-Baker going for the reverse dive with Pike.
Oh, it's another steady dive from the home pairing. No, not quite as precise as maybe the Chinese or some of the other pairings, but that's going to keep them in the race in this early stage. Probably about the same as they got on their first dive, just over the 50-point mark, which is where they want to be. There's a little tip of over there, Nick Robinson-Baker closest to us. Good synchro, good execution. Stay with it, boys. There we are, whistles and claps from the rest of the team.
Yeah, enthusiastic support from them and from the crowd, and 52.20 the scores. Remember, all those scores with a line across them do not count towards the total score. Yana Castillo Huerta and Julian Sanchez Gallegos with their second round dive. This will be a back dive with Pike, the last of their compulsory dives.
And it's good, 2 out of 2 for Mexico. I wasn't sure whether they'd be a bit shaky on their first two as their counterparts up on the platform were. Seb going for the blue taping on his lower back, the diver furthest away from us. A bit of a taping display today. I do have an answer to the other taping, which I'll share with you shortly. As we see the Mexican replay there, synchro's good. It's going to get 8.5s. Keep them in contention. Probably bang on the 50 point, just over, just under. I might move them down a little bit. Let's wait and see.
Yeah, it's getting very tight at the top. 50.40 at the moment. There's only 0.6 separating the top three. But we haven't seen the best yet. And they're coming next after we've seen the Malaysians. We're getting into the stride very quickly on the reverse dive.
Oh, it's beautiful. You have reverse dive in the tuck position. The tuck obviously bending at the hips and at the knees, pulling the shins in with your hands. Obviously diving, looking for toe point elegance, precision, poise, etc., etc. But look at this. The Malaysians doing a good job. As you can see, arms moving, heads back into the water, maybe marginally out of time. Distances from the diving board, but it's good. 8.5. The coaches like it.
But they always do.
Got to keep the coaches happy.
Very rare, apart from the occasional Russian or Ukraine coach, you see them really get downbeat or upset by a dive. To keep the morale of the diver up. Here's Chin and Luo, who are the world champions. And they're going to probably show us again exactly why that might be, with a reverse dive and the puck in the pike position.
Yeah, no pucks from the Chinese, just the pike position, the reverse dive in the pike. And as you would expect, a marvellous second round dive. Yeah, I don't think we're going to see any tens, but this isn't far away from perfection. Arm swing up, touch the toes at the same time. No light in between the chest and the thighs. Execution a little bit over, diver closest to us, Lou. So I think he's going to get penalized. King Kai, exceptional diver in his own right. Beautiful execution. Let's see.
Oh, there's a 10 there, but it won't count. There's a 7 there. That won't count either. So just the 9.5 on the left, just the 9.5 for China. And they go into first place. Yeah, sorry about the puck reference. I thought I was in Vancouver doing the Winter Olympics again there for a moment. On to the Ukraine. Kavasha and Prigorov. Pike position dive. It will be a reverse dive worth 2.0.
Yes, very steady second round dive. And just to give you the answer to the taping mystery, apparently that style of taping helps with power generation and lymphatic drainage for a current or previously injured site. Thank you to Twitter for letting me know and all those experts out there. Let's see if it works for Ukraine as they go on. That's going to leave them a little bit at the bottom of the field. As we can see, all experts in synchronized diving were looking for movements at the same time, which the Ukrainians are doing, maybe different distances from the diving board.
Well, the tape's not working at the moment. I'm going to have to rewind it, I think. 51 for Ukraine. Now, Canada with Ross and Despartie. Second round dive, a reverse dive with Pike.
Oh, it looked as though it was going to go all a little bit wrong there. As you can see, the approaches seem to be a little bit out in time. I think they got it together in the end. The judges will, well, they can't ignore that. Let's have a look here in the slow motion. Despartie just slightly back from the end of the diving board. In and out of the pikes, moving arms that is dissimilar to, oh, you know, it's not going to be a really low marks, but they're going to be a little bit off the pace with that, and they might struggle to get over 50 points. Oh, clapping anyway, but they know, I know, they know. Needs to be better than that, boys.
You don't convince us when you don't, you really don't. 50.40, and look at those marks that have been taken away and the ones that have been added to their score. So, the end of the second round. That's the preliminaries, if you like, out of the way, because the big stuff is to come. China lead from Russia. Joint third are Malaysia and Mexico and the USA. And then Canada and Great Britain. Look at the spread. Hardly any between 2 and 8. 3.6 between silver medal and the bottom of the pile after round two. This is where it gets interesting. This is where it gets a little bit more complicated and a little bit more risk assessment, if you like.
A lot more complicated. A lot more complicated.
Well, we're going to go straight away from 2.0 to 3.4 for the opening round three dive. For the Russians, inward 3.5 somersaults with tuck. And they've got 3.5s and a 3.8 to end up with. So it gradually gets more difficult for Zakharov and Kuznetsov.
Oh, wow, the Russians are betting big, and it certainly looks like it's going to pay off. We saw the Mexicans do that 2 days ago in the men's event. The Russians flexing their biceps, obviously been doing their beach weights because these are big, big dives. In with 3.5. Look at that, spinning forwards towards the diving board 3.5 times. It's 3.4 degree of difficulty, and they made it look easy. Bang on with the synchro. If that gets over 80 points, then the Russians are certainly going to be hard to catch. Maybe one team, as we mentioned, might be up there with them.
Well, they've been second the last two World Championships, and with dives like that, it's not hard to find out or see why. 84.66, a decent return on round three for them. We're really waiting for the Americans to get going in this competition. This would be a good time to start. Yep. With Christian Ibsen and Troy Dume with their forward 3.5 somersaults with Pike.
Wow, beautiful dive. It needed to be the Americans completely opposite to the Russians playing safe. That's only a 3.1 degree of difficulty. So if you're going to play safe, you need to nail it. And to be fair, that's exactly what the Americans have done. You're looking at 80 points plus to stay in contention. Of course, the Russians were 84, I think. These guys, lower degree of difficulty, forward 3.5, pike position there, into the water, very good.
Well, the sound of this competition has been very, very good from the outset. And another 80 score for the USA. Now, the first of the big dives for the Brits, for Chris Mears and Nick Robinson-Baker. It's a reverse 2.5 somersaults, 1.5 twists, and they want to get into this pretty quickly.
Oh, and they do. They're a little shaky maybe on their first two. This is a big dive to open up with. It is 3.3, waving the flag there, synonymous with Team GB. These guys doing Team GB proud so far. That's 3 out of 3 dives for Baker, Robinson Baker and Chris Mears. Should get 8s on synchro. Look at the strain on the faces and the body. Every single muscle being activated. Anyone thinks you don't need to be fit to be a diver? Have a look at that replay.
77.22 Again, the seven count and the 3-8 on the right-hand side all go towards the score. He's happy. What do you think, Chris? Not giving too much away. Mexico with Yael Castillo Huerta and Julian Sanchez Gallegos. And it is an inward 3.5 somersaults with Tuck. We're back in mid-three territory, 3.4. Currently standing in third place, equal third.
Oh, here we go, Mexico again. How many times am I going to be saying that? This, wow. I've just been looking at the rest of the dives to come for Mexico, and they are backloading their list. They've got some big DD. They're going to be dive for dive with the Russians. And if the Mexicans continue on the wave that they're on at the moment, they're going to be difficult to beat. This is going to sail over 80 points, may even top the Russians, and certainly puts the pressure on the Chinese. Coaches like it, and so they should.
Vamos,
get in, Mexico.
Vamos, Mexico. 86.70. Take that, and party. What about that? On to Lomas and Huang of Malaysia. So you might remember Brian Lomas, who's about 4'1". He's grown up a bit since the early days when we saw him in diving.
Yeah, it's a really, really nice dive, but they are being slightly out-tariffed, out-DD'd, and outclassed marginally by some of the other pairs. Normally, you would be seeing a lot of the pairs use this one forward 3.5 in the pike position. Many of the teams opting for the forward 4.5. We'll make a fuss of that when it turns up. This will not get over 80 points, and it means that Malaysia will be battling with GB at the bottom of the pack so far.
78.12 just shows you how high the standard is. We think that 78 is not particularly good in this competition. If you're not getting 80s at the moment, then you're not really in the reckoning. On to China, Chin Kai and Liu Long, and they are going for 3.4 straight in with one of their big dives forward 2.5 somersaults, two twists in the pike position. Numero uno.
Oh, interesting. Bob looking over to me expectantly, and that certainly wasn't what I was expecting. It's still very good. The synchronization is spot on. The execution, Liu Yutong closest to us. He's short of the vertical as he goes in. There we are, 2.5, two twists. Loads going on in that dive. Look at that, the synchronization's good. They should still get eights on synchronization. Should be penalized for slightly poor execution. It's a big DD, it's 3.4, so it's gonna get over 80 points. Shouldn't really be higher than early 80s. Well, come on, judges. That's a little bit generous in my opinion.
Well, I'm with you on that. What do you think at home? 85 does seem a little bit generous, but it does put China where they were, back at the top of the pile, but yeah, there can be sometimes marks up on reputation. Kavasha and Prigorov, 3.4 for them, in with 3.5.
Well, that's more like it. The Olympic silver medalist from 4 years ago, the surprise Olympic bronze medalist from 4 years ago, I might add. Certainly showing some of the form that's been maybe eluding them for the past few contests, or certainly the past few years, but that's a big dive. And they certainly need to catch up after an okay first two rounds. That's going to sail over 80 points, and that's exactly where they need to be.
Well, they're coming back into a bit of form recently. Bronze in Beijing, as we mentioned, and also European bronze medalist just a few weeks ago. So perhaps they come into a little bit of form right now. And that would indicate they've got the cobwebs out of the way. Now, we'll wait and see Ruben Ross and Alexander Despartie start to make their move up the standings. And their first big dive of the day is a back 2.5 somersaults with pike. Only 3.0 degree of difficulty, the lowest of these they'll do.
Yeah, it's a low DD, so it needs to be absolutely outstanding. And it isn't far away from outstanding. It's going to get nines on the synchro, I'm sure. Needs to be a little bit better, though, because 3.0, you're just going to give them away. Actually, they're spinning at different times. I was looking at Alex Despartie's execution, which is very good. That's certainly worth a nine. But there we go. That's going to leave the Canadians off the pace. Weak start, round three.
Yeah, and if you start to get 15, 16, 18 points, yes, intake a breath there from Leon. As we see, the lowest mark so far in that round, 72, puts the Canadians at the bottom of the table at the halfway stage. Here's a 1-8 as it currently looks then. China, Mexico, Russia, USA, Ukraine, Malaysia, GB, and Canada at the bottom. As you can see, Mexico and China only separated by 2.5 marks. Very tight.
And the Russians only 1 point behind the Mexicans. Game on.
Yeah, it's a nice open competition, this. Look at those stands. Absolutely full to the brim, which is exactly what London 2012 should be all about. Round four for the Russians. And this is the dive with a little bit, shall we say, of danger attached to it. Reverse 3.5 somersaults with tuck. Actually, it's a back 3.5.
Yeah, it's the back 3.5. They're the only pair brave enough to do this. Such a difficult dive. You need a 3.5-meter springboard at least to do this. These boys, wow, they really are, you know, raising the bar in springboard diving. Wow, what a dive. I was watching it in training thinking, how's this going to go for them? You know, is it going to be the one that costs them? You know, I don't think it's going to get over 80 points, but wow, they're betting big and they're going to put the pressure on. Oh, 79.8.
Well, where did those chips fall? Not quite the right side as far as they were concerned. Probably because I told them they were doing the wrong dive. Christian Ibsen and Troy Dumais with their fourth round dive, reverse 2.5 somersaults, 1.5 twists in the pike position, 3.3 degree of difficulty. So I think you know where we're going with this right now.
Oh, wow. They're just so consistent. So consistent. I've been watching them in training. They're just going plonk, 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 landing on their heads every time, vertical. And that's exactly what you need to be doing. That's got nines written all over it. Reverse, 1.5 twists. Here's the 2.5 somersaults. Great synchronization. Make no mistake, if you are not on your game, the Americans will take you out today. Wow, here you go.
Awaiting the hat dance later on. Yeah. Mexico are very much in contention for not only a silver, they keep this up, there's pressure on the Chinese, 90. 0.09 points. That is the highest we have seen so far today. Now the Brits, Mears and Robinson Baker.
Oh, it's good, it's solid. A little discrepancy in the middle of the dive on the twist, and I can explain that in more detail, but that's quite technical. Let's just see on the replay. Landing on the end, Robinson Baker closest to us. Here's 1.5 somersaults. Out into the twist. Mears is just stronger than Robinson Baker, so he needs to come out earlier to complete the twist. Chris is obviously younger than Nick. Nick's getting on a bit, feeling a bit tired maybe. He won't mind me. I'm a good friend of his.
That.
Yeah, there we go. Good dive from the GB boys. Getting close to that 80-point mark, which is where they need to be to challenge.
Expecting a Christmas card this year. 78.54 from Mears and Robinson Baker. But that's okay. Now to the Mexicans, Castillo, Huerta, Sanchez, Gallegos, forward 4.5. Here's the biggie. How will it go?
Oh, well, they're all over the shop at the start, but they hit the water at the same time. Now, the judges always get confused by this, and so do I. I don't know what you do with that, because in the rule book, you should be in time all the way. Look, he's... he didn't even do an arm swing. Diver furthest from us. How the goodness me managed to do a forward 4.5 is beyond me. That could have been all over for Team Mexico, but somehow they've managed to hang on, and this degree of difficulty is 3.8. That means it's going to be a big score with low execution and lower synchro marks. They're probably... There we are, 6.5, 7, 7 synchro. The judges didn't really know what to do with it.
That reminded me of a tumble dryer, the way that was going. They were going in different directions there, but they finally got it together when they entered the water.
It could have been a lot worse, though, Bob. The way he landed on the end of the diving board, he could have shot out towards the swimming pool. That isn't a good look.
Here comes Huang and Lomas with their latest dive.
Oh, solid again. Team Malaysia, again, a little bit off the degree of difficulty, which means that the execution needs to be even more precise. And they're not far away. Look at this. Here we are. Reverse again, spinning backwards towards the diving board. 1.5 twists into that pike shape. As you can see there, the synchronization is very good. Execution diver closest to us or to the left of screen now isn't quite as good as Brian right of screen. But that's going to get them close to 80 points.
On the money, 80.19, 7.5 counts on the left, 8.58 and 8 on the right for the Malaysian pair. Now, a bit of pressure on the Chinese, not running away with it yet. Jinkai Luo Yutong. And it's the inward 3.5 somersaults with tuck for them as their fourth round dive.
Oh, it's a sensational effort. Synchronization near on faultless. Lulu Tong closest to us, making a bit of a hash-up of his entry into the water. He'll be quite cross with himself. Done all the hard work. Look at that. Perfect unison. And then I think he misses his hands. Instead of punching a hole in the water, he claps his hands and they bounce apart. See if we can see here. Yeah, not quite getting that entry into the water he needed. Getting the water out of his ears then again so he can hear his coach say, that wasn't good enough, you need to do better next time. But there we go, 88 from the Chinese.
999 on the right, no emergency yet though for China. On to the Ukraine, Gavasha and Prigorov. Oh, here's a biggie, 3.8 again, forward 4.5.
Oh, it's high risk and I think that's going to be good enough for them. Wow, Ukrainians making a bit of a comeback, maybe a shaky start. Forward 4.5, 3.8, quite a few of the teams using this today. Here we go, let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4.5. Your eyes are in the back of your head by the time you get to there. All the gravity's wanting to rip you out of that shape. You need incredible strength to hang on in there. Yeah, good work from the Ukrainian divers.
Very slow start, they're getting into their rhythm now. 87.78, and from being at the bottom of the pile, they're starting to move their way forward. Rated like the blue touch paper, maybe. Ruben Ross and Alexander Despatie, round 4 for the Canadians.
Oh, it's very solid. Again, the approaches are marginally different on the timings, which will give the impression to the judges that they're out of sync, when actually the dive itself, they do get it together in the end. The Canadians, like the British, are lacking a little bit on the DD at the moment, so they need to be raising their game. That's a really good dive, though, 3.4. It'll get over 80 points, but they've got some ground to make up after their first dive, and so I think they're going to be bottom of the pack, which is unusual for this experienced Canadian pair.
Well, Alex has picked up so many medals over the year. He's used to being on... Now, what's happening here? He's disappearing off. I thought he might be going for a medical timeout there for a moment, the way he was dashing around the back. I hope he's okay, because it might be a good time. So we just look at the scoreboard here to explain in a moment what's wrong with him. But end of round 4, China, USA, Ukraine, 1, 2, 3. Great Britain in 7th place, just, and I mean just, 1 point above Canada. So, Alex Despatie, the problem.
Yeah, well, I don't think I haven't got enough time to list everything that's wrong with him. I'm just kidding. He's a good friend of mine. Unfortunately, Alex had 6 weeks ago had an accident in the diving pool. He'd probably tell you on the dive that they're going to be performing last. So I'll give you more details as the competition unfolds. But it's good to see him here. He's been stitched up and put back together. And here are the Russian pair.
Round 5. Zakharov and Kuznetsov with their reverse 3.5 somersaults in the tuck position.
Hello, Russia. I've been looking forward to saying that. That is excellent. 3.5 degree of difficulty. This is going to be a massive score. Hurdle step into the end of the diving board. Arm swing, reverse, spinning backwards towards the diving board. Both safe distances from the diving board. Beautiful entries into the water. Slight discrepancy on the distance from the diving board. Those executions are 8.5s, the synchro's 8.5s, it's 3.5 degree of difficulty. Hello, almost 90 points.
89.25 for the Russians. I think it's quite the place for Leon Taylor to be doing his audition for Radio Moscow, but nonetheless, that's the opening dive of round 5. On to the USA, and Troy Dumais, and Christian Ibsen going 4. A reverse 3.5 somersault with tuck. You want to know the position in terms of the tariff. It's 3.5 attached to this dive.
Oh, it's the biggest dive from the US. It's the 3.5. The Russians have just nailed theirs. The US having to carry all that pressure. And they've done a good job. Troy DeMay, furthest away from us there, has had some troubles in the past with this dive. In fact, he's even hit his head on the diving board on several occasions. I'm pleased to say he's a safe distance from it today. Troy absolutely nails his. Christian Ibsen faltering slightly furthest away from us now. But the synchronization is on. That's going to get them over 80 points. That guy in the crowd really likes it. Yeah, so do the US divers.
Eights will count on the right. Eights will count on the left for the USA, who move for the time being into first place. But there is nothing between the top two, USA and Russia, at this stage. Chris Mears and Nick Robinson-Baker going for an inward 3.5 somersaults with tuck, 3.4 degree of difficulty. And at the moment, considering they weren't qualified for this event, only here as host nation, they're doing better than anticipated.
And on they go. I was watching in training, having a little bit of a challenge with this one, but obviously lifted by this home support, because that's a really, really good effort from the boys there. Inward 3.5, standing backwards, swinging the arm, spinning forwards towards the diving board. Doing a great job there. Chris Mears especially, very, very good execution. Hello, over 80 points. Coaches like it, I like it. Good work.
Now, do the judges like it? That's more important. Yeah, Nick likes it. 84.66 for the Brits. That is their best mark by quite some way in the competition so far. Here come the Mexicans, Castillo Huerta and Sanchez Gallegos with their reverse 3.5.
Ooh, surf is up indeed. Wow, there you go. That's the Mexicans out of the hunt for the medals, unfortunately. You cannot afford to make a mistake of this magnitude in this final. Every single one of these dives counts. It looks okay so far. The synchronization is spot on. Both divers kick up too high towards the ceiling. And then, as you can see there, time to get your surfboards out. Look at this. Waves. Wow. So execution marks will be low. 6 and 5.5 carry. Synchronization 6.5. So only 65 points. See ya.
Yeah, so it's not going to be another silver medal. We've got two silvers already this week in other competitions, but I think that run's going to come to an end right here. Now, Lomas and Huang going for there. Inward 3.5. Dive you've seen before, 3.4 degree of difficulty.
Oh, the house of cards. There's Brian Lomax landing on his back almost, doing a forward roll into the water rather than the vertical entry, which is what the judges are looking for. Here we go. These dives are so, so difficult. It's giving you a real indication. That synchro's bang on. Uh-oh. There we go. He will. Oh, that's such a feeling. When you hit the water, you just go, oh, that's it. Straight over, onto your back, onto your calves. Yeah, what can you do? No magic rewind button. 4 for Brian's dive there. Synchronization marks impacted.
They would like that one back again. Because 63.24 is not a good follow-up to an 80 that they got in the previous round. Now, the Chinese, if they were to falter, perhaps it would be on this one. This is the biggest tariff dive that anybody does here. 3.8, forward 4.5. You've seen it before, you've seen it done well, you've seen it done quite badly. Now, normally, you'd expect the Chinese to be spot on. 3.8, biggest degree of difficulty attached to this one.
Oh, sensational! Well, if any of you were wondering if the Chinese were going to come in and give away gold number 4, I can safely tell you the answer to that is no way. Wow, this is the dive of the meet so far. This is going to get over 100 points. Their synchronization is spot on. Execution, wow. I do not have superlatives good enough to tell you how good that dive is. And I don't normally see that particular Chinese coach as ecstatic as that. And my goodness me, I can tell you why.
Woo! No 10s, though. Only 9.5s.
104.88.
Yeah, I was expecting a 10 to crop up there, but one didn't. But nonetheless, 104.88. Thank you, China. And good night. Gavasha and Brigorov for the Ukraine.
Oh, obviously inspired by the Mexicans making an error, sniffing out those medals that are available. forward, 2.5, 2 twists, complex, lots going on. Landing on the end of the diving board, spinning forwards 1.5 times, out, double twist, disorientating, but they managed to figure it out. Diver closest to us, a little bit short of vertical, which means the execution mark will be a bit lower, but it's steady. It'll get them, if it gets them over 80 points, which I suspect it will, that's going to keep them there. The tape's working. Keep the tape on.
Rewind and then turn it over again. Kvasia and Prigorov have moved up to fourth place after a very unpromising, shall we say, start to their campaign. Now, it's not been a great day so far. There's a little bit of time to make things up for Ross and Despartis on their reverse 2.5 somersaults, 1.5 twists.
Yeah, they need to do more than that. I think it's already a little bit too far out of their grasp for the medals. They're diving very consistently. And of course, Alex, with that injury, meant that lots of time out of training. He's doing so well to be here. Still the individual event to go. Differing distances from the diving board, hitting the water at the same time. You know, it's going to be 80 points, but I think they're a little bit too far off the pace now to catch up. Ruben Rossev almost bending his knees to get the pike shape in. I wonder if the judges will see that. Of course, the judges do not get the benefit of the replay. That's for us. And there's the mark.
80.19 for Canada means they are in sixth place. The big cheer will be explained when you see the eight standings. China, USA, Russia, Ukraine, and then Great Britain in fifth. A lot of people expected them not to be above eighth. Well, they made three places up on Canada, Mexico, and Malaysia so far, with another round to go. But it looks like Chinese gold once again. Look at the battle, though, for the silver and bronze.
This is a big, big dive for the Russians. Big, big dive for the Russians.
It's the biggest dive for the Russians. It is that 3.8 tariff. Now, if they want to be medal contenders today, this has to go well. It's the forward 4.5 somersaults for Zakharov and Kuznetsov.
Oh, here we go, Russia! Wow! Now, if you were wondering whether the Russians were going to open the door to the Americans, or anyone else for that matter, the answer to that is no, we're not. Big dive, 3.8, 4.5 somersaults. We watched the Chinese nail it. Not quite as good as the Chinese, but that is as good as I've seen it from the Russians. And what a time to do it. Here, last dive, Olympic final, diving for a medal. And now they will definitely finish on the podium for that one. What colour will it be? Let's wait and see.
We await
big,
the marks.
Big, big, big dive.
Oh yes, they're past the 100 mark. Only China have done that up till now. But Russia sneaking over the three figures. No tens, nines, and a 9 and 8 on the left-hand side. So Russia have moved into pole position. Of course, Chinese have yet to have their last round dive. So what have you got, USA? Not as big a tariff dive, so hard to make up those points. They're not going to make up those points, really, with that 0.4 differential. Forward 2.5 somersaults, 2 twists and pikes. So the USA pretty much know they're going for bronze.
Oh, it's a sensational dive to finish. They need perfect tens to get the silver medal from the Russians. That is not going to happen, but that might just be good enough for the bronze. We shall have to wait and see early on, putting the pressure on the other divers. I think they've got a big enough lead over the Ukrainians, but you never really know. You never really know. The US have really come out all guns blazing today. Lower degree of difficulty than a lot of the pairs. Execution has been faultless. Classy diving from the American pair. That's going to get 86. Wow.
They squeezed about as much out of that dive as they could points-wise. 86.70, 8.5s right across the board. And they finished with 446.70. Will that be good enough for bronze? Now, the big dive is the last dive for Great Britain. This is the huge tariff. A lot of risk attached to it. If it goes well, as we've seen, a lot of points. Come on, compose yourself, Nick. Don't get carried away with the moment. 3.8 forward, four and a half. If the crowd could do the dive for them, they would, but they've got to do it for themselves.
Oh, they've done a good job. I was watching it in training and it was a little bit all over the shop. But that is very, very good. That was the Mears' there, Chris's mum and dad. Chris obviously had a tough, tough route here. You know, nearly passed away a few years ago with a severe illness in Australia. So good to see him here today at 19 years old. Forward, four and a half. Beautiful synchronization. Just goes to show how difficult this dive is. A little bit over vertical from both divers, and embrace there at the end. They've done a fantastic job today. That could hold them in the spot they're in. Come on, where are those marks? The computer's melting, obviously.
I'm liking, hopefully you're like, oh, the crowd want more. They're not happy with that. We've got booze here. Not happy with that.
They're obviously all experts, aren't they, Bob? They know exactly what they're watching.
I think 87.78 is pretty fair, actually,
fantastic
for the judges.
Fantastic score. What a list. 4.32 from the homeboys. Very, very good.
Mears and Robinson Baker can be very proud of their day's work. Now the Mexicans, who look to be going very well, all of a sudden the wheels came off for Castillo Huerta and Sanchez Gallegos. And here is their final dive. Only 3.4, a mere bagatelle.
Well, it's not only 3.4. 3.4 is still extremely difficult, but the Mexicans, as we saw from Waterfield and Daily 2 days ago, you make one mistake and that's it, you're out of it. These guys have left themselves too much to do. There's a double twist and into the pike shape. Synchronization is good. Too much to do for Mexico today. They will not be in the medals.
And they get 78.54 now confirmed on your screen. The execution problem on the right hand side. Synchro 8.0. The score for the Mexicans. On to Malaysia with Brian Lomas and Huang. And their world rather came apart in dive number five. 3.4 again, that forward 2.5 with two twists in the pike position. Final dive for Malaysia.
Oh, it's a solid performance, mainly from the Malaysians today. Up on that fifth round dive, which did, a couple of their dives maybe a little bit off. I mean, they're, here we go. 1.5 out into the double twist. And it's really good, it's 3.4. You know, they're just a little bit off the pace today. Oh, missing his hands as he entered the water there, diver closest to us. Let's see what the judges see.
Yeah, how much of that did the judges actually see at first looking? 78.54. They will finish below Mexico and Great Britain with that score and are in danger of actually being bottom of the whole competition. A lot of that depending on Canada at the end. China waiting again to be anointed with the gold medal, as they have been on the previous three occasions in the synchro here, both the tens and the women's three. Here's Ching Kai and Luo Yutong with their reverse 2.5 somersaults, 1.5 twists, 3.3 to finish off for them.
Well, finishing with near on perfection, that's gold number four for China without a shadow of a doubt. The flags are waving, the coaches will be clapping, and you've got to applaud. What a supreme diving nation. 4 out of 4 for China. Perfect dive to finish, 90 points I suspect. And clear winners, sailed over 100 points on the previous dive. Catch me if you can, and no one can. There you go, confirmation.
89.10, it'll be clear by a full 18 points over the Russians. It was close for a while, but then they got going. And when they get going, they are unstoppable, as they proved again today. That's how it looks right now. Not quite the final score, because we have some divers still to come. Just an indication of what the top three looks like. And Ukraine, to get into the medals, well, they need and 90. They're not going to get it from a 3.3. Reverse 2.5 with 1.5 twists.
Well, I don't think that's going to be good enough. That could be good enough for fourth. They need, 9.5s across the board, and that's only going to get a mixed bag of 8s to 9s. Well, they fought valiantly today, but the Americans and their consistency mean that that'll be the US in bronze, Russia in silver, and the Chinese are a country mile ahead in the gold medal position. Now, these guys were in fourth going into this dive. That isn't good enough to take away the Americans' bronze medal, so I suspect that they'll be in fourth place to finish.
And here comes the confirmation of what Leon Taylor has just told you. 79.20, 8 and 8.5 on the left. They count the ones with the mark struck through, do not, and that's going to put them 14 points behind the USA in fourth place, but above Great Britain and Mexico. Well, it's been a disappointment for Departi and Ross. This is the dive that caused Alex so many problems a few weeks ago back in Canada as they were preparing for it. I'm not quite sure what's going through his mind right now as he thinks about a competition dive of this magnitude. It is that inward 3.5 with Tuck, 3.4. We wish him and his Canadian partner well on this dive.
Oh, it's a superb finish. Synchronization, excellent. Both divers a little bit over vertical. But on this particular dive, 6 weeks ago in a Rome training camp, Alexander Departi hit his head on the diving board. You can see here, safe distance. 6 weeks ago, he sliced his head open. He's had 20 stitches in his forehead. And they've done a really, really neat job there. You know, just to get here, to get back to compete, you know, that's going to put them, where did they finish? 82 points. Does that put them six?
Yep, sixth place will confirm the order for you, but not close to the medals today for Ross and Departi. The Russians are celebrating their silver. Another day at the office. They're perpetual silver medalists, aren't they? They're consistent. They've done it yet again, have the Russians. Second of the last two worlds. European champions and now Olympic silver medalists, but you cannot usurp the Chinese, despite the fact for a little while they were being pulled back by the rest, but no. And the USA always happy to be on the podium, and they are there again with Dumais and Ipsen. Things starting to turn around for the Americans over last year. They didn't look great at the World Championships last year.
That's fantastic. So that's three medals so far out of four for the US. Russia, of course, achieving their first Olympic medal of these games. Not so dominant anymore, Team Russia, but a very, very dominant performance today. But who can touch the Chinese? No one today. Let's wait and see as we go into the individuals for the remainder of these Olympic Games. But, well, I don't know about you, Bob, but I certainly haven't been disappointed with those four diving competitions. They've been full of everything. And today, again, wow, people really betting big, big dives, big degrees of difficulty, and a fantastic performance by the home team. Nicholas Robinson-Baker and Chris Mears. Very, very good indeed.
Here comes the final standings for you. China 4.77, winning by 18 points very nearly. Russia in second, USA in third, Ukraine missing out. But look at that, 4.32.60 for Great Britain. Great effort by Mears and Robinson-Baker. And bringing up the rear, Canada, Mexico, and at the bottom, Malaysia. What a great competition that was. It really was. And just underlining what we were saying just now, we haven't been disappointed because the quality has been so high. And these boys there, Mears and Robinson-Baker, have delighted this crowd and provoked the first boos that we've actually heard during the diving competitions here at the Aquatic Centre. The crowd weren't happy. They thought that 3.8 was worth a little bit more, didn't they?
Yeah, I think they certainly did. And what the boys did there was they capitalised on the mistakes made by some of the other teams. Malaysia off their game. Mexico, one big mistake. Canada not quite working as smoothly as normal. Our boys putting in a big, big performance. 4.32.60. earns them a well-deserved fifth spot behind the big guns. And my goodness me, those big guns were firing today.
Impressed with the Russians. They pretty much set the tone with that first dive today. They came out with purpose, nailed their first dive, and kind of said, right, we're here and we're here for a medal, and you're not going to push us out of the way.
Yeah, there's the Russian support team, Ilya's family, I would imagine, as they've got Ilya t-shirts on. It's just a guess, but I'm sure I can...
That's quite an inspired guess, I'd say.
Not
Leon.
A bad guess. Wow, and like you said earlier, Bob, there isn't a empty seat in the house. Diving, you know, is so popular, and it's a delight for us to bring it to you wherever you're watching from. And there's a hot ticket in town because the crowds are not being disappointed. You know, valiant performances from the British pairs and some exceptional diving from the rest of the world. My goodness me. I'm glad I'm in the commentary box now and not still doing it.
Not that you ever did three, did you? Did you ever do three?
Three what?
Three metre.
I did three, a big one, 3 metre earlier in the days. Yeah, I was a platform specialist. They're too easy, springboards.
Obviously far more to get wrong when you're on the concrete. By the way, did you know there's 462 tonnes of concrete in those boards?
No, they're impressive though, aren't they? That's what I know. Iconic venue here in London. And what I do know is that in order to get the diving boards looking as they are, they had to do full size polystyrene, design of them, as in, like, you know, with all the same models. Yeah, exactly, thank you. With all the dimensions in order to see from an engineer. It's a massive engineering feat. I don't have more details than that, but it's very, very impressive because I've never been anywhere else in the world that looks a patch on that. That is just, well, beautiful, isn't it?
And we should explain that when you see the long shot, you will see there's obviously other diving boards we're going to use here, the 3 and the 10. There's no one in the Olympics, and there's some intermediary boards. What service, what sort of kind of job do they provide for the divers?
Yeah, that's right. So you don't just go from the lowest board all the way up to the highest board. There's stepping stones, if you will, in between different stages, and certainly the younger divers, age group divers all around the world get to use the 5 metre, the 7.5 metre. The 3 metre platform is actually a training aid in order to start working on the takeoffs. It's safer when you're a bit lower. Very important that you have a full complement of diving boards. And what you don't see here is at the back, there's the dry land training area, which is where the trampolines are, the dry boards, which is a diving springboard onto crash mats. You've got stretching areas, somersault boxes. The divers are very gymnastics. They do gymnastics in their training. Very specific to diving, though. So warm-ups are, you know, about getting the muscles firing, getting those legs and arms moving quickly. Lots of, you know, conditioning involved. And these divers are in top shape. What you're watching today, and oh my goodness, you know, just the bar is continually being raised, 4.5s by a lot of the athletes here today, and wow, they're doing them so well, aren't they?
So a 4th and 2/5 for Great Britain so far, and of course a 7th with the girls on day one. Is that a good reward? Is that a decent return?
It's a fantastic result, you know. I think rewind 2 days ago, and we can see how well close we were to that to the rostrum with Daly and Waterfield. I'm still deflated by that now because the guys did they did all the hard work. One mistake, as we know, and we saw that from the Mexicans today. The girls yesterday in the platform, you know, they were just slightly outclassed by the rest of the world. You know, they still retain their European number one, you know, top spot, but they were beaten by the Chinese, the Mexicans, the Canadians and the Australians, who of course aren't in Europe. So, you know, you can't fault the performances, you know, the efforts there, working hard. Just a shame we haven't got any home medals.
Expectations of the individual, which kicks in 2 days' time.
Well, if the synchronized diving standard is anything to go by, we and you all at home are in for a real treat. Now, I'm not going to put the mouth on anyone by naming names or putting medals, but of course, you know, the nation expects, you know, a challenge in the men's platform. Thomas Daly, Peter Waterfield, home interest. There's lots of media following those two. And Jack Law's probably worth a shout in the men's 3 metre individual. Only 17 years old. Chris Mears already got his Olympic experience today. He's going to be all guns blazing, riding on a high from a 5th place there. So, and then, of course, all of you, the audience around the world, you're going to be in for a real treat because everyone's going to be featuring in the individual events. 32 divers on average in the preliminaries, cut to 18 for the semi-finals, and then cut to 12 for the final. The scores do not carry through. It's all about that C word again, consistency.
What about the chances of anybody other than the Chinese winning an event? Will we have to wait till the final day like Matthew Mitchum had to 4 years ago for things to change and get a slight change in perspective in terms of the countries that are winning the medals?
Oh, look, I don't know. It's, you know, the men's platform 4 years ago isn't as strong as it is now from a Chinese perspective. You've got Kibo, Mr. Perfect Score, as he's known at in China, or something along those lines. And he's, you know, he relishes the pressure. He's going to be unfazed by, you know, the partisan audience that are going to be behind Daly and Waterfield. So I don't think that's a weak event for China. In fact, China do not have a weak event at all.
Is Mitchum still strong? Because Mitchum took a bit of a year off last year, didn't he?
Yeah, he's had some injury troubles. And so I can't really say. He's certainly an exceptional diver, and he knows what it's like to win in Olympic Games, so he can never be discounted. And he's probably enjoying the fact that he's not under that much pressure, because it's all, you know, all the attention's on Kubo and Tom Daly. So he could be the you know, waiting in the wings, you know, to come around the top bend and cross the victory line. So, well, you know, I'm not going to get ahead of myself. We've got a lot of diving before we get to the blue ribbon event, the men's platform. You know, women's springboard is what kicks off first. Day off diving tomorrow, and then back in on the third.
Other sports have talked about how beneficial London 2012 could be for them, and hopefully will be for them. What about the legacy for diving from this?
Well, look at this fantastic venue. Crystal Palace National Sports Centre has seen better days from a facility point of view. And this is the capital city of the UK. And, you know, what a delight to have a venue like this. And as we know where we're sitting now, Bob, we're in the, you know, complete temporary seats. You know, this is going to be a 2,000-seater or so venue, I believe. It's going to be very functional. There is this whole, you know, programme that will be executed as soon as the celebration of the Paralympics is finished, and it will be converted into legacy mode. And this is, of course, a permanent venue on the park. The seats are temporary, but there will be some left. But it's just going to be a fantastic venue, and there will be plans in place for a high performance centre to be here in London, coaches in place, and you know, give the population in this area more choice.
Which is a dramatic backdrop. So obviously Barcelona, where you competed, is an outdoor venue, so it's bound to be. But in terms of the structure of this, the roof of this, they're going to take some going to get a better facility and a more dramatic one than this, aren't they?
Oh, it's fabulous, isn't it? You know, look at the all the sporting facilities here on Olympic Park. I know some of them are temporary, but a lot of them will be here when the Olympic and Paralympic Games have completed. And you know, if you don't like you know, it in the aquatic centre, then you nip down the road and try something else. So for the legacy and the youth and the you know, there's the big O word, isn't there? It's opportunity. The only reason that I became an Olympic medalist in diving is because I had the opportunity to try diving. I was brought up in Cheltenham Spa. And luckily for me, there was a small diving pool there at the local baths, and there was a diving club. And so I was able to try it. And that's what you want. You want the opportunity for these people who are excited at home watching the diving to give it a whirl. And I encourage you to do just that. It's an exciting sport.
We are ready for the victory ceremony for the men's synchronized 3-meter springboard. Just to remind you of the pairs you will not be seeing climbing aboard that rostrum. From 8 up to 4. It was Malaysia in 8th place with Huang and Lomas. Castilla Huerta and Sanchez Gallegos in 7th. Departi and Ross in 6th. And the British pair of Mears and Robinson Baker 5. Ukraine just missing out. Actually missing out by 14 points in the end from that bronze medal. But here come the divers who got their top 3 placing. Taking their respective places left to right. Russia, the silver medalists. China in the middle. And the USA to the right-hand side. This is all in a day's work for the Chinese. Russians absolutely thrilled once again to be number 2 on the podium. And the Americans had to work hard with some consistent dives. 90, 84, and then 86. In their last 3 dives. Those Russians were the only other pair apart from China to hit the 100 mark, which they did with the last dive, 100.32. Here is the presentation party for the men's synchronized 3-meter springboard final with members of FINA, which is the world governing body for aquatic sports, involving swimming, diving, synchronized swimming, water polo, and open water these days. So the bronze medal, as American diving is really on the up and up since the World Championships last year, where they rather underperformed. Not been the case in London. Great cheer for Dumay and Ibsen of the USA. Bronze medal for them with 446.70 points. And to be fair, pretty consistent all the way through. Their compulsory dives, 51.6 and 53.4. And then they never dropped below 80 and got one 90 plus score. So the USA picking up the bronze. Big smiles, always happy to be involved in the medal action, and one more to add to the USA total. Been tough for the Russians so far this week. But, they started with aplomb, so with a very impressive opening dive, which was their back dive, and never really looked back. Certainly didn't look back when they got to 100.32 on their last dive, and that secured the silver medal. The men in the most garish outfits, I think, of any team here at the Olympics. You need glasses for that. Well, if you looked at it, you need glasses after you've looked at it. It's the Russians. Kuznetsov and Zakharov. Another one to add to their collection. Silver medals in plenty of quantities over the last year or so. Good job done by Russia, getting an appreciative reaction from the crowd. Plenty of whom have stayed behind to see this victory ceremony. And there'll be quite a few Chinese flags flying in just a few moments, because a big Chinese population in and around London have attended here, but Russians take their bow with their huge, and they are huge, silver medals. Massive. Now Chinese go on their little victory walk, if you like, round the podium, shaking the hands of the Americans and now the Russians before they return back to base. You see the presentation party aren't standing right in front of the medal podium. In fact, they just did it in anticipation of the gold medal this time. And then he had a waltz between the Chinese and the gentleman with the flowers and the medal yesterday. So they got their saunter in early. Well, they're going to be hard to beat at the World Championships next year as well. Hard to beat at any time, but it's just a slight falter. It really wasn't much of one on their second round dive. After that, it was 85s, 88, and then 104. Biggest score of the competition, 104.88 to be precise, in dive number 5, and that pretty much put the tin lid on the victory. So China do it again. All 4 synchronized diving events go to China. The latest for Liu and Chin. Chances are we'll be hearing that anthem a few more times before the diving events have been completed a week on Saturday. Now we have a day's break before we are back again on Friday. Friday afternoon, UK time, to watch the 3-meter individual for women. And Leon, looking forward to that. And again, probably going to be Chinese domination, but who's going to be taking up the available medal? It's because if we get a Chinese one too, it's only number 3, isn't it?
Well, let's wait and see. Let's take the day off tomorrow and come back fresh, 2:30 local time on Friday, the women's 3-meter prelim. But this is more of a marathon. We've got the preliminary cut to 18. All divers go through to the semi-final. Semi-final, you all start at 0, diving in reverse order. Top 12 go through to the final, start at 0, and then we can start talking about the medals then.
Yeah, okay, right. I got your message. I get the message, and we'll give you the messages and hopefully some more entertainment from the Aquatic Centre right in the heart of Olympic Park here in London. I hope you've enjoyed the competition today. It was a very, very high standard, as indeed have been the 3 previous synchro competitions. But we're back to the individual as of Friday. So from the Aquatic Centre in London, from Leon Taylor and myself, Bob Mallard, we'll see you in a couple of days' time.